This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Pemberton Mill was a large factory in Lawrence, Massachusetts, which collapsed without warning on January 10, 1860 in what is likely the worst industrial accident in Massachusetts history and one of the worst industrial calamities in American history. An estimated 145 workers were killed and 166 injured. Contents 1. Description 2. Collapse 3. Victims 4. Aftermath 5. See also 6. Bibliography 7. References. Description. David Nevins Sr. was co-owner of the Pemberton Mill at the time of the disaster. The Pemberton Mill, built in 1853, was a five-story building 280 feet long and 84 feet wide. Its chief engineer was Charles H. Bigelow, and its construction was financed by John A. Lowell and his brother-in-law J. Pickering Putnam at a cost of $850,000, a fortune for those times. During a financial panic in 1857, Lowell and Putnam sold the mill to George Howe and David Nevins Sr. for a $350,000 loss. The new owners jammed more machinery into their factory, attempting to boost its profits. The mill ran with great success, earning $1,500,000 per year, and had 2,700 spindles and 700 looms in operation at the time of the disaster. Collapse. Shortly before 5 p.m. on a Tuesday afternoon, workers in nearby factories watched with horror as the Pemberton Mill buckled and then collapsed with a mighty crash. According to later court testimony reported by the New York Times, owner George Howe escaped as the structure was falling. Dozens were killed instantly, and more than 600 workers, many of them women and children, were trapped in the twisted ruins when the winter sun set. Rescuers built bonfires to illuminate their efforts, revealing faces crushed beyond recognition, open wounds in which the bones showed through a paste of dried blood, brick dust, and shredded clothing. Around 9:30 p.m., with many people still trapped in the twisted wreck of the factory, someone accidentally knocked over an oil lantern. Flames raced across the cotton waste and splintered wood. Driven back by the conflagration, the screams coming from the ruins were soon silenced, leaving rescuers to eventually discover only the burned, smoldering remains of brick, mortar, and human bones, promiscuously mingled. The Boston Almanac and Business Directory notes the event by describing that the Pemberton Mills at Lawrence, Mass. Pemberton collapsed. Tons of machinery crashed down through crumpling floors, dragging trapped, screaming victims along in their downward path. At a few minutes after 5, the factory was a heap of twisted iron, splintered beams, pulverized bricks, and agonized, imprisoned human flesh. Victims' estimates of the number killed by the collapse and subsequent fire vary from 90 to 145. Most were recent immigrants, either Irish or Scots, many of them young women. A 2002 fictionalization of the disaster recounted, flames spread rapidly, and now terror of fire threatened those waiting to be saved. Mary Bannon, pinned in the wreckage, handed her pay envelope to the friend comforting her and asked that it get to her father. "Bid him goodbye for me," she said. "You will be saved. I will not." While Irish and Scots were the majority, the list of the Pemberton Mills casualties is indicative of New England's labor force at that time. There were also Yankees from Maine and New Hampshire, immigrants from Germany and Switzerland, and others. All the churches of Lawrence. The new Pemberton Mill, built shortly after the collapse of the first. The collapse of the Pemberton Mill was determined to have been caused by a number of preventable factors, ignoring already questionable load limits. Extra heavy machinery had been crowded into the upper floors of the factory. Investigators also discovered substandard construction. The brick walls were improperly mortared and supported. The iron pillars supporting the floors were cheap and brittle, but had been installed nonetheless in the wake of the disaster. Area ministers delivered sermons on God's inscrutable wrath, but it was apparent that blame lay in the manner in which the factory was built and operated. The Scientific American wrote, "There is now no doubt that the fall of the building was owing to the most gross negligence and want of fidelity in casting the columns." The tragedy became a rallying point for efforts to improve safety standards in industrial workplaces. It also inspired the popular sketch, "The 10th of January," by author Elizabeth Stuart Phelps Ward. David Nevins Sr. bought out his partner and rebuilt the mill after his death. It passed to his sons, David Nevins Jr. and Henry Cotton Nevins. The mill still stands today. See also Tor Lawrence, a location-based documentary and interactive history trail about two sisters who worked in the Pemberton Mill in 1860. 2013 Savah Building Collapse, the deadliest industrial accident in history. Citation needed. Grover Shoe Factory Disaster. List of industrial disasters. Bibliography. Little, George P. 1860 The Fireman's Own Book, Chapter, Destruction of the Pemberton Mills, Lawrence, Mass. pp. Lawrence additional testimony further subscriptions progress in relieving the sufferers New York Times January 21, 1860 carat ABCDEFGHIJ The Working Ladies of Lowell American Heritage Magazine carat AB genealogical and personal memoirs relating to the families of Boston and Eastern Massachusetts William Richard Cutter Lewis Historical Publishing Company 1908 carat Dyer John J 1860 An Authentic History of the Lawrence Calamity Boston J.J. Dyer P.